Well, the summer movie season is definitely here, and that includes many scary movies. But is the genre healthy for our keiki? Psychologist Dr. Alana Coffey is here with more in this morning's Keiki Talk. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Good topic. Good topic, because The Conjuring 2 is out, right?
It's
a spooky one. Why do we watch horror movies? And more importantly, why are children so drawn to them?
I think human beings in general are drawn to things that are scary. That's one of our defense mechanisms, mm-hmm. is to look out in the world for danger and help keep ourselves safe. But, you know, we've been telling children scary stories since time.
Right.
That's how we keep them safe. We ask them to pay attention to certain things.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like Little Red Riding Hood. If you think about that story, it's very scary.
Yeah.
So we've done this for a long time.
So, but why do we make them into movies?
Excitement.
Yeah.
But no, I think, again, the benefit of the movie. So I think one of the reasons why people make the movies is because it's something that's speaking in our culture.
Mm-hmm.
There's some things that are scaring us in a certain kind of way. It's a collective unconscious, and it allows the human to see natural disasters in a safe but distant way, and maybe encounter really scary content, but on screen. It helps us to maybe get ready and process some very scary content.
I want to put some information on the rating system that was currently in place, because there's a reason we should be following this.
Yeah.
Every child is different, though, right?
Yes.
So the parents at home are going to be watching this and say, okay, doctor, when can I take my child to a scary movie? Is there an age appropriate for that?
Well, I think the Motion Picture Association of America has some guidelines on that, right? So they talk about G movies, and I've mm-hmm. seen some G movies that are very scary. The Think Bambi, again,
right,
very
right.
scary content. Again, children are individually different, so you should know your child. But try to follow these guidelines. I think it can't really steer you wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So what they don't do is add ages there. So I'll try to fill that out a little bit. G age maybe up until about, you know, 9, 10. By the time you hit tweens, that's when we're looking at that PG, parental mm-hmm. guidance, the tween. It's just beginning to think about the world in broad perspectives and really be able to understand things. But by the time they're 13, that's that PG-13 there. That's a very creative and broad-minded adolescent person. So they can see scary movies, but we should still be there to mm-hmm. process with them. What did you see? What were the lessons inherent in the movie? How can that benefit you? Rated R movies, super exciting, but very scary, even for adult people.
Right.
Like, we should watch these in groups and process them later. And NC-17, that's one we seldom think about, but no one under 17 is actually admitted to
right.
those films, right?
Okay, so yeah, mom and dad used to always say, don't play with the Ouija board. And then as soon as they left, we play with the Ouija board.
Yes, of course.
So same with the don't watch that scary movie, but if they get the chance, they will. Just monitor
they
what they take.
Do.
It.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, coming up, have a great weekend.
Thank you.
Boo! Okay. That wasn't scary.
Bye.